Hello. I'm Oriana from Zyxel Networks. Welcome to our Tech Talk. In this new series, we will discuss about Wi-Fi deployment. We're thrilled to have all of you here as we dive into the essential aspects of setting up a Wi-Fi network in an efficient and tailored manner. The deployment not only includes AP placement, but also other tasks. In this episode, we will focus on the crucial initial steps when setting up a Wi-Fi network. They are requirement analysis and access point selection. These steps are instrumental in ensuring a successful Wi-Fi deployment that meets your specific needs. When it comes to setting up a Wi-Fi network, understanding your specific needs is the key. By taking the time to identify and collect this information, we can make informed decisions that not only meet our requirements, but also ensure cost-effectiveness. We can consider the following questions to better understand your requirements. First, how many devices will be connected to the Wi-Fi network? Knowing the number is the key in determining the capacity and performance requirements of your access point. By estimating the number of devices, you can ensure that your Wi-Fi network can handle the simultaneous connections without experiencing congestion or slowdowns. For the average household, the number of devices usually isn't a problem. After all, the quantity won't be too high. However, if we're talking about a restaurant or a small office, you'll have more people in your area. If too many people are occupying the same channel at once, it can negatively impact everyone's performance. To achieve better performance, it's recommended to plan for approximately 40 people per access point. If you're aiming for a higher number of concurrent users, you can consider planning for 80 people per access point. Please note that, if the number of client devices exceed the number, you may consider to deploy more APs to share the loading. Next, let's turn to talk about the coverage and size of the venue. You may expect a single AP can cover all the areas. But actually, each AP has limited signal. Therefore, it's crucial to ensure you get enough access points that can effectively cover your required places without any dead spots or areas with weak signal. Some people may wonder why signal strength matters. Well, as you are using the smartphone to watch Netflix or browse internet, your device is also communicating with the AP. So, if the device is close to AP, the signal is strong, and the connection is very stable. On the other hand, if station is far from AP, the signal may be too low, and result in interrupted service. In the indoor environment, Zyxel recommend that each AP can provide stable performance within a radius of 15 meters. Of course, there will still be signal received beyond that range, but it may be more susceptible to interference from obstacles like walls, which can make the performance less stable. Users can use this as a benchmark to analyze how many APs are needed to fully cover their homes or areas where internet access is required. For example, a venue with 50 meter square may require 3 to 4 APs to provide adequate coverage for their needs. And the third point, we can further analyze what network applications will be used through Wi-Fi. Different internet applications have varying requirements for resources. Broadly speaking, we can classify different applications into two categories, those with high demands for network quality and those with low demands. Examples of applications with high demands include video calls, high-definition streaming, and gaming. Those applications require either higher throughput for larger data or less interfered wireless channel to avoid video lagging and any service interrupted. On the other hand, applications with low demands include instant messaging, web browsing, and general smart home devices. They usually require lower data throughput and have better tolerance to retransmission, due to they are not time-sensitive application. If the majority of your time is spent on high-demand applications, it's clear that you should choose higher specification products when making a purchase. Conversely, lower specification products can adequately meet the requirements of the majority of other applications. Once you have a clear understanding of your requirements, it's time to select the right access point for your Wi-Fi network. First and most important thing we need to consider when making the decision is always the transmission rate of each product. On shopping websites, you will come across descriptions of access points like AX5400 or AX1800, which represent to the aggregate throughput of each AP. The higher the number, the better the performance of the product can provide. When you require higher quality network performance for your applications, you can choose a product with a higher aggregate throughput. For example, if an AP is deployed near your living room, where family member will watching Netflix together, then you should choose AX5400 for better performance. On the other hand, if an AP is provide signal for corner places just for instant message use, then AX1800 can afford the data usage. To further explain, this aggregate throughput are mainly determined by the technology or Wi-Fi standard used for transmission. In today's networks, Wi-Fi 6 or AX is the mainstream and stable technology. On the other hand, you may also encounter products with Wi-Fi 6E or AXE capability, which is a new protocol that offers higher speeds. So if you are aiming for a future-proof network environment, AXE will be good for you. Today, we have learned how to analyze our own needs from several dimensions and use them to choose the right access point for our requirements. This will help you make informed decisions when faced with different product specifications. By making informed choices based on these factors, you can ensure a reliable and efficient network environment for yourself. Zyxel offers a wide range of products. Welcome to visit our official website to make your selection. You can see the specs mentioned above are clearly noted in the page. For more purchasing information, kindly check the Where to Buy in the top menu bar and get the purchasing window that suits you most. Well, that's it for today's Tech Talk. Hope this episode was able to give you an idea of how to analyze your requirement and select the appropriate AP that meets your needs. In the next episode, we will introduce some guideline to place your newly purchased AP at right location, so you can have stable connection with less interfered Wi-Fi transmission. Like, comment, and subscribe. And I hope to see you in our next episode. Have a nice day.
We're Zyxel, and we're your networking ally.